Good afternoon, everybody. At first, on behalf of Gurudas College Library and IQAC, I welcome you all in this Gurudas College webinar 2020. And today, the topic of the webinar will be institutional waste management, an essential parameter for NAC accreditation. And let us start today's program through the welcome message from our Honorable Principal Madam. It is a great pleasure for me to announce that Gurudas College Library and IQAC are jointly organizing this webinar on Institutional Waste Management, an essential parameter for NAC accreditation. Today, 11th July 2020. Waste management is very important today as the environmental deterioration is going worse gradually by the indiscriminate disposal of waste materials. There are different types of waste like solid waste, liquid waste, e-waste, chemical waste, biomedical waste, industrial waste, and so on. Students should know about the adverse effect of this waste on human being as well as on environment. Separating, reducing, reusing, and recycling are good options for managing industrial waste. We would like the participants, especially the students who are the future of our society, to have a learning experience during this webinar about an important topic from Mr. Nandan Mall, who has experience in e-waste management for 2 years in abroad. Hope this webinar will be helpful to all to you all. I wish all the success for this webinar. So after the presentation or message of the principal madam, may I request the honorable convener of IQAC Gurudas College, Professor Triporna Mojumdar, to say something about this webinar. Madam.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. On behalf of the Internal Quality Assurance Cell, Gurudas College, I welcome you all to today's webinar titled Institutional Waste Management, an Essential Parameter for NAC Accreditation. This webinar is the 9th one organized by us. The webinar is jointly organized by Gurudas College Library and Internal Quality Assurance Cell, Gurudas College. Our speaker today is Mr. Nandan Mall. Mr. Mall is the founder and CEO of Huladec, the company with which we have moved for the last couple of years. I'm grateful to our librarian, Dr. Joydeep Chondo, for selecting today's topic. Since creating awareness among people about waste management is the need of the hour. We need to protect our environment through effective waste management. Educational institutions like ours generate solid waste, liquid waste, and e-waste, which need to be managed properly. Now, we are in the process of the third cycle of NAC accreditation. We have already submitted the self-study report, which we call SSR in short, to NAC. While working on the preparation of the SSR, we found that NAC has given due importance to waste management. On our behalf of the college, we have taken some steps to manage waste. I will request Dr. Joydeep Chondo to brief us about the steps taken by our college in this regard. I am certain that today's lecture will improve the existing waste management techniques adopted in educational institutions like ours. Thank you. Over to you, Joydeep.
Thank you, Triporna-di. You have talked the issues regarding why we have selected this particular topic of today's webinar. Actually, when you are going through NAC SSR, we have seen that there is a particular criteria, sub-criteria actually, on institutional waste management. That is 7.1.5, I think, I remember. And you know that regarding disposal of waste, we are more or less accustomed with this in our home or in our office or in our college. We just maintain or dispose our waste on a regular basis. We just gather waste in a particular bin, and in every day we just dispose it through municipal VAT or municipal staff member just take waste regularly. That's the issue. That's the process actually. But the regular disposal of waste and waste management is quite different. disposal of waste is quite a narrower term, whereas the waste management is the broader term. And when we just try to preparing our SSR, there are three issues: solid waste management, liquid waste management, and e-waste management. So regarding our college, we are maintaining solid, managing our solid waste through regular disposal by our municipal corporation, number one. And regarding liquid waste management, more or less the chemical waste actually from the laboratories, we just manage it as and when required through proper channel. And regarding e-waste, we have just a move with Hulatech Recycling Private Limited, and they will look after the task of total e-waste and paper waste management. So regarding difference between disposal and management, regarding management, we have many, many social roles. It includes the recycling of waste, regular waste, that not included in the disposal method. Recycling of waste means we have to recycle the waste for the betterment of the society, that will not make any harm to the society. So we are when you are looking for any partner or any agency for our waste management procedure, we are very much fortunate that coincidentally at that time Hulatech Recycling Private Limited approached us to look after the task of this waste management, and we have agreed on a mutual agreement, I think in 2018, for e-waste and paper waste management. That's the issue. And so we are very much fortunate that Mr. Nandan Mall, the Honorable CEO and the proprietor and founder of Hulatech Recycling Private Limited, has agreed to say something about the total procedure of waste management, not only e-waste, but solid waste, liquid waste, and other waste management, and also the certification and recycling procedure. Recycling procedure, and about Mr. Nandan Mall from Gurudas College, and about Mr. Mall, when he just I have heard from his father that when he has approached his father to for better study of waste management in Spain, normally it is not a quite popular subject at that time, but his father agreed. And he just agreed, and permitted to allow him just to go to Spain for better training of waste management. So for this, after his training of 2 years, he founded Hulatech Recycling Private Limited in 2014, and this particular company looks after the task of e-waste management, paper waste management, and many other things throughout the country, especially in the I think in West Bengal. So may I request Mr. Nandan Mall to start your presentation, sir.
Right. Thank you so much, everyone. It's been great to be here, and I'm happy to help you out today with the concept of institutional waste management and the overall concept. I'll try and keep it very, very simple. And during the entire process, if anyone feels that they have any question that they would like to present or anything that they would like to clarify with me, I would be very happy to answer that. And please feel free to write it in the chat, and we'll definitely get in touch and respond to that. Also, in case there is anything you want to reach out to our company for, the details will be shared at the end of the presentation. So I will just be sharing my screen. Okay. So as you can see on your screen, guys, that you know, you can see this heap of big waste that is there. And you know Annie Leonard, she's a very, very senior proponent of sustainability. She's spoken at the World Sustainability Forum, and she's been a part of the United Nations as well. She gave a very, very famous quote 2 years ago that there is no such thing as away. When we throw anything away, it must go somewhere, right? And so, you know, with this concept today, I would like to start the seminar on institutional waste management, explaining to you what the idea is overall. Also, I would like to speak that why in the current scenario, especially of COVID and overall sustainability, is waste management very, very essential, and why it needs to be done properly. Anyway, it was important to be done, but furthermore, now it is required to be done in a proper manner. Okay. So, firstly, we'll come to the types of waste. As you can see that there is, I think the screen share, there is a problem. Right. So as you can see, the types of waste, there is dry waste, there is dry waste, which is paper, plastic, packaging waste, inorganic waste, of various types, metal waste and glass waste. These are a few types of plastic dry waste that is generated. I'm sure in all our schools, colleges, homes, etc., this kind of waste is found quite commonly, right? Next, of course, is wet waste. As you can see, there is food waste, which is primarily a major part of wet waste. You have cooked and uncooked food, fruits, vegetables, flour, agriculture waste, biodegradable, and glass only in case of materials like bottles of Coca-Cola or Pepsi or stuff like that. That can be termed also as wet waste, since the residue of the Coke and Thumbs Up is there in that. But other than that, it is considered as a dry waste. So definitely in terms of institutional waste, from every organization or every household or every commercial unit, dry and wet waste is very commonly found. Next, of course, is our area of specialization, which is e-waste, right? As you can see, the heaps and piles of e-waste that is there on the screen. So there are electrical goods, electronic goods, wires, batteries, bulbs, and tube lights. Now, primarily to understand what exactly e-waste is and what do we do with it. So India approximately sees that the average life of a cell phone in our country is about 2 years. So every 2 years, on an average, our country replaces, or a citizen replaces, his or her mobile phone. And India in 2019 sold about 283 million such mobile phones. So assuming that these 283 million pieces of mobile phones will become e-waste in the next year, this is just one example to show you that how much e-waste is getting generated in our country. 300 million computers and almost 1 billion cell phones go into production every year across the world. Approximately 1 billion cell phones are made every year across the world. About 300 million cell phones, computers and desktops are also made. And all of this has a shelf life of between 2 to 5 years. So all of these products become end of life after 2 to 5 years, and that it becomes ultimately into e-waste. Then, of course, there's our hazardous elements, hazardous waste such as chemical waste, medical waste, ignitable waste, anything that can catch fire, etc. Corrosive and reactive materials, and of course, overall, everything else is toxic materials as well. So, overall, this is the four types of primary waste that is found. Now, of course, we want to speak about overall the scenario of waste management in the country, and overall how the things work. And so we have been running this campaign for the last 6 months or so, where we call it Sabko Batao E-Waste Ghatao. The idea behind this campaign is to ensure that everyone gets to know about waste management in general, and specifically about e-waste management, right? And they get to know how e-waste is generated, what are the harms associated with e-waste, and overall how can the big problem of e-waste be solved. And therefore we have started this campaign where we go to colleges, we go to schools, to residential areas, etc., and we speak about waste management and specifically about e-waste management as well, right? So I hope everyone who's watching us on YouTube live, can you connect with us on the chat? Is it possible for people to connect on the chat, or is it just viewing only? In case people can chat, please let me know.
Yes, they can chat, no problem about it.
Sorry?
Yeah, they can chat, no problem.
They can chat, right? Okay. So what I will expect from everyone is I will be doing a small survey, and I will expect everyone to just answer as much as possible, so that we will try and be a little more interactive, and okay. So what we are trying to understand is, what is your e-footprint, right? How much e-waste do you generate? How much e-waste does an average citizen of the country generate? And to track this, we are going to be looking at some questions which cause e-waste to get generated. Certain actions or certain things that you do at your level cause e-waste to get generated. So we will just be checking that and understanding how much of you agree. So this is a simple point rating system. I hope all of you have a pen and paper next to you, right? If you don't, I will just give you a minute. Please get a pen and paper, right? And I will also get it. I have mine right here, right? I will be noting this as well, right? That what is your e-footprint? How much e-waste are you generating, right? So I hope everyone has their pen and paper. We'll be going. So you simply have to give yourself points. Okay, how? You will see. Okay, my first question is, have you ever broken your phone screen? Now I want to see the answers in the chat box. I want to see the answers in the chat box for people. Either yes or no, please let me know. Yes, have you ever broken your phone screen? I have personally. Yes. Okay. Yes. Some answers I think are coming in already. And yes, absolutely. Okay. Yes. So definitely. So I think 20 points gets added there. I have definitely broken my home screen. I think you all, also most of you, must have. Okay. Do you have a midnight snack at night? Do you waste your refrigerator's electricity, causing it to get damaged a little earlier than it probably should? Yes, I think we all have the midnight craving, and we all definitely raid the refrigerator for a midnight snack. We definitely do that. 20 points there. Okay, how many of us do this? Do we use the AC all night? As you understand, air conditioners generate chlorofluorocarbons, and these chlorofluorocarbons are very, very detrimental and have a very bad impact on the environment. So do we run the AC for 8, 10, 12 hours when we are sleeping at night? Do we do it? I personally don't. I'm a little more, cautious about this. So no, I think that is 10 points for me, right? Has this ever happened? Has the average life of your phone reduced because maybe you dropped it in the toilet? Has it ever happened, guys? Kabhi aisa hua ki gir gaya toilet mein ya bheeg gaya pani mein, jiske wajah se absolutely okay working phone is suddenly becoming end of life or suddenly become non-working? Yeah, personally has not happened with me, but I have seen a lot of people who have done it as well, right? So definitely that is also something that we can see. Okay, how many of us have done this? Now the single largest cause of the remote being damaged is because we all bang the remote in our hands when they are not working, and of course the battery life gets a thing, and also the overall device gets physically damaged, because naturally when you're banging something against the floor or the wall, naturally that will get damaged. yeah, I think I have done that as well. So definitely we are all guilty of this. So definitely 20 points here as well. Next, of course, is do you need the geyser even during the summers? As you know, geysers contain copper, steel. Devices, if not properly used, if not resourcefully used, obviously get damaged much faster as compared to any other device. And therefore, you know, the geyser, if you use it during the summers as well, then that's a bad thing. I think we should avoid it. Lastly, how many of us, you know, how many times do we charge our phone in one day? I'm sure the iPhone users have to do it more than once a day. Yeah, I think everyone has that problem. Maybe with Android users, it's a little less. But as you know, the phone battery, of course, the more you charge it, the more the battery gets damaged. And therefore, there's a higher chance of e-waste getting generated, or more and more e-waste gets generated when you charge your phone a multiple amount of time in a single day. So that is also a major, major reason why e-waste gets generated. So let's calculate the score. How many of you have scored how much? I personally have scored 110. So definitely I am in a good place, but I still need to become a rock star. I don't know about you guys, how much you scored. I hope you had good scores. If not, people in the third bracket, definitely lots of work needs to be done and definitely a lot of improvements is required. Yeah. So I hope this gave you a little bit of a practical insight on how e-waste is generated, how you can prevent and reduce the generation of e-waste by doing everyday activities, by doing normal things that you probably forget to do or probably do not realize you are doing in the normal course of work. And then, of course, it lands up costing you much more in the end. Yeah. So, coming to e-waste, and let's understand, as we all understand that e-waste is primarily old electronic and electrical devices, which means that any device or any technology, when it was once new, but when it becomes old, it can be converted into e-waste, right? What is e-waste? Let's quickly look. E-waste is primarily old, broken, obsolete and outdated electronic and electrical materials. What exactly do I mean by that? So any device which is old, when I say old, what do I mean? That for each electronic and electrical device, the government of India has identified an average life, right? There's an average life for each electronic and electrical device. Therefore, once an electronic and electrical device becomes away or crosses the average life that has been assigned, it is considered to be old and therefore it can be considered as e-waste, right? So that is one reason why e-waste gets generated. Secondly, of course, you know, it is broken, which means that any device which is physically damaged, which gets damaged due to any other reason, right, that device is considered as broken and can cause overall damage to the thing. And that is why it can be called e-waste as well. Of course, then there is outdated and obsolete devices, right? Outdated is when, like I said, better technology replaces old technology. That is when electronics become outdated and that is when e-waste is generated. And obsolete is when either the parts of the electronic device are not available or the manufacturing of the parts or the device itself is stopped. That is when we can consider that to be obsolete. Now, I would like some of you to answer this question. What do you think is the correct answer? How much e-waste does India generate in 1 year? Right? Is it 1.36? Is it 2.03? Or is it 0.8 million tons? Okay. Yes. So, Approximately 2.03 million tons is the total amount of e-waste that gets generated in our country every year. That is a mammoth figure, and that's a big figure to deal with. You know, 2.03 million tons is a lot of waste, and barely 5% of that total waste gets properly recycled right now. When I say properly recycled, I mean as per proper channel, as per proper recycling tools and methods are occupied. That is only when 5% of 2.03 million tons gets recycled in a proper manner. Rest of it, where does it go? It goes here, right? So this is a very typical person who we call a kawadi wala or a bikri wala. Right, this is the person who comes to our homes, our colleges, our schools, and of course takes the e-waste material away. But what it does with it primarily is that he sells it to the local scrap dealers or the kabadiwalas, and whatever necessary materials can be removed, can be extracted, are extracted. But rest of the material which cannot be extracted is simply dumped, simply thrown, right? And that's how it is. So yes, this is how overall e-waste is currently being handled. So whatever cannot be recycled or cannot be used is simply thrown or dumped away, right? And that is a serious problem, because e-waste contains certain elements which of course can cause a lot of environmental damage, right? For example, when we are throwing this e-waste either in the landfill or in the water, it firstly causes a lot of air, soil and water pollution. Now, if we do not understand how this is bad, overall air, soil and water pollution is definitely an issue, and e-waste being dumped into the natural resources cannot be a solution to solving this mammoth 2 million tons a year problem of e-waste management. So harmful substances in e-waste which cause health issues are also identified. For example, phosphorus, lead, cadmium and mercury, which are found in e-waste, cause a lot of environmental as well as health issues. For example, lead, which is found in batteries and which is found in other electronic waste, is a very carcinogenic substance. It causes cancer, right? It does not work too well and causes cancer to all the people who are dealing with e-waste. And also, if it found its way in the air or in the water and soil, it is carcinogenic, so it gets carried on and this causes a lot of damage. Also, cadmium, again found in batteries, mercury found in vapor form in tube lights, can be very harmful and very scary, because mercury in general is very scary. When a tube light breaks, there is a mercury vapor that gets released into the atmosphere, and when that mercury vapor gets released, it causes a lot of environmental as well as health issues. And therefore, it is very important and very cautiously important for us to understand what are the harmful substances that are found in electronic waste, how are they being treated and disposed of, and overall, how is the waste management stream being managed? Otherwise, it can cause a lot of fatal health issues as well. So, just to understand from you that all of you, of course, have been facing this issue of COVID as we all speak. And, we all are living in the current time where COVID is a serious problem, and we all need to figure out a way how to deal with it. Now, during this time of COVID, it is further more important to have, proper waste management. The major reason why it is there is because COVID-19 is currently known as a surface virus, right? Which means that if a virus enters a particular place, it enters a particular locality or it enters a particular campus, the virus spreads through touching and staying on various surfaces. And of course, waste which is lying in our homes, in our colleges, in our schools for many, many years together offers such services to the virus. Therefore, it is very, very important and very, very crucial that the viruses need to not have a space where the surface is available, where the virus can stay and grow. And therefore, it is very, very imperative that all the waste that is currently lying or which is no longer of use needs to be disposed of immediately. Second, of course, you know, the disposing of unnecessary and old and unused equipment will reduce the overall risk of the virus being present, will reduce the overall problems that we might face because of the virus. And therefore, it is important for us to ensure that proper waste management happens during the time of COVID. And lastly, of course, if there is no waste currently there in your premises, there is no waste currently lying, it is easier to clean and maintain the hygiene of the place. It is easier to overall sanitize the place and make sure that we are COVID-free and that we are safe. And therefore, e-waste management particularly becomes very, very important in the given scenario, because e-waste is a big surface item. It has a lot of surface on it, and therefore this waste needs to be disposed of as soon as possible. Yes. So letting you know a little bit about Huladec, exactly what we do and what we are working as. We are a producer responsibility organization. What do we mean by that? We help various producers, that is brand owners like LG, Samsung, etc., in managing their extended producer responsibility. What do we mean by extended producer responsibility? This is the responsibility that has been given to them by the various governments of India, the state and the central governments, that whatever waste is being generated out of the products that they have manufactured, that they have sold in the market, whenever that product becomes end of life or whenever that product generates waste, that material needs to be collected and needs to be disposed of in a proper environment friendly way, in an environment friendly solution. So like everyone was saying at the beginning of the presentation as well, that waste management is an essential part of NAC accreditation, primarily because it is the responsibility of every bulk generator of waste and every producer of waste to ensure that whatever waste is getting generated needs to be disposed of in a proper manner, needs to be collected and recycled as per the environment norms and as per the guidelines of the central as well as state pollution control board. So we at Huladec work as a producer responsibility organization. We help various brand owners, various producers, various bulk generators of e-waste in handling their e-waste, not only handling their e-waste but also ensuring it gets recycled in a proper manner, and also proper certification and audit compliances are provided from our side so that e-waste is properly disposed of and you are also getting good accreditations and good scores in the overall compliance standards of the country. So that's how Huladec works as a PRO or a producer responsibility organization. To simply explain our process, how do we do it? You give us a pickup confirmation. As soon as we receive a pickup confirmation, we collect the e-waste, either it is from schools, colleges, hotels, hospitals, whatever it is. Of course, once the material is collected, the segregation is performed. When material is segregated into various types, into various zones, and after the segregation is done, finally the material is transported and it is sent for proper recycling and disposal to Central Pollution Control Board and various state pollution control board authorized recyclers and dismantlers, right? Therefore, it is important for us to know the process of e-waste management. It is important for us to overall check the scenario, and it is important for us to know how things can be done. So just to let you know a little bit about our services, what do we do? Of course, we provide door-to-door pickup services, right? So we can come to your home, schools, colleges, etc., and pick up the waste from your door without any extra charges for that. We of course provide data destruction services. So any material that needs to be disposed of first has some secure data in it. It is very important and imperative that this data needs to be destroyed. This data needs to be taken care of, so we provide that service as well. We also conduct a lot of awareness drives, like we are conducting one right now. We help a lot of the candidates, a lot of the students to, you know about e-waste management, look at career opportunities on e-waste management, understand about the overall scenario of e-waste, what are the harms, what are the various issues with it, and how we can solve it. That is also another thing that we do. We do awareness drives. Lastly, like I said, we help the producers in fulfilling their obligation, in fulfilling their responsibility, right? So we provide extended producer responsibility related services as well, where we help the producers in collecting material and channelizing it for proper recycling. So as per the e-waste management rules 2016, it is the responsibility of the producers or the brand owners of electronics and electricals to ensure that the material that is sold by them, once it becomes end of life or when it becomes e-waste, it needs to be properly collected, channelized, and stored for recycling by the authorized recycling companies of the various state and central pollution control boards. So we help various such bulk consumers as well as producers to collect such waste and to dispose it off and to provide proper certification as well. So I hope you all enjoyed the presentation. I hope you will all pledge to recycle today. I hope you will all ensure that whatever e-waste that you are generating in your homes, schools, colleges, offices, etc., is properly getting collected, properly getting channelized, and properly getting recycled. With that, I will take your leave. Please feel free to ask me any questions. Please feel free to ask any suggestions, any clarifications. I'm happy to help. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Nandan. There are some questions, and also I am requesting on behalf of the college, if you have any question, you can check it now. So one after another, I just highlight the question on the screen. Please go through the screen actually. Okay, this is the question.
Okay, thank you, Abrojit. That's a good question. Yes, so gaseous waste is definitely a problem in today's day and age, as you mentioned. And there are certain incineration processes to handle such waste. Yes, aerosols and deodorants currently in our country need to be controlled incinerated. That means that the material is sent in a controlled incineration equipment machine, which is generally done not in the municipal areas but more in the outskirts due to lack of fear of population being affected by it. And these substances are then incinerated, burnt, and whatever carbon or other residue that comes out of this burning is then reused for other purposes. But yes, there can be better ways of managing gaseous waste, and we can definitely look at this in the future.
My question is that, is there any problem of collecting waste? Any managerial problem from the end of the institution, affiliating institutions? Is there any managerial problem?
Okay, yes, problems are there. Not that the problems are not there. First of course, problem is that people are not sure what is the waste. They need to understand what is the e-waste material. They need to understand that e-waste needs to be recycled in a proper manner. So this awareness issues are there with the management of various associations, that they are not too sure if they want to dispose of the e-waste with us. Secondly, of course, there are certain pricing issues, because you know, kabadiwalas or scrap dealers offer better prices or offer very, very high prices for certain items, because proper recycling and environment norms are not met. So likewise, that is another challenge that we face in terms of collection of waste. Okay. Hello, Mr. Roy. Good question. Thank you so much. Yes, it can be managed at the institutional level by first identifying a space to have an e-waste collection bin. If you have an e-waste collection bin, which can be disposed of, you know, can be all the e-waste that is being generated can be disposed of in that bin. In Gurudas College, already we have the same facility where if you have any e-waste, you can dispose it off in the e-waste collection bin, so that the waste gets segregated, does not get mixed with other dry waste or other wet waste, right? And that's how at an institutional level you can first manage your e-waste. Secondly, of course, through a technical person, identify what actually is e-waste and what can be repaired, because repair and reuse is always preferred over recycling. So if you can repair and reuse something, first try and do that. In case you cannot do that, then you should try and recycle. Okay. Hello, Mr. Mondal. Yes, so there is no specific figure that I can quote at this stage, but through the website called Green E and through various efforts of METI, which is Ministry of IT, Information Technology, and through the Central Pollution Control Board and Ministry of Environment, a lot of awareness programs are being conducted on e-waste management. A lot of capacity building programs for entrepreneurs or for collection partners is being done by the government. A lot of strict penalties and strict implementation of law is being done with factories and other private organizations which are in the manufacturing process of electronics. And also a lot of strict policies are being implemented with the producers of e-waste. So specifically, a lot of these initiatives are being done by the government, and I'm sure that costs in you know, billions of rupees. So yes, the central government and various state governments have been quite active about this issue in the last 2 to 3 years. Okay. Hi Shubhuna. Yes, so I am not too sure about this personally, because like I said, chemical waste is generally incinerated as per my understanding. Specifically in a laboratory, I think it needs to be given to a hazardous waste management organization. In West Bengal, we have West Bengal Waste Management Limited, which is a hazardous waste handling organization which handles chemical waste. So that can be disposed of to them and they will be incinerating it. But at the chemical level per se, I don't think, at the laboratory level, I don't think anything can be done. It just needs to be handed over to the right person. I don't think that's possible, Akash. We'll have to speak to ISRO regarding that. I'm not too aware and I cannot comment on this topic. I do not think out of earth is a challenge, and frankly, why do we need to take it out of earth? Because almost 90% of all waste materials are recyclable, so they can be reutilized, they can be recycled, and they can be made better use. So why would we want to send it out of earth? It's a resource, and we should keep our resource with our planet. Otherwise the transformers will come and they will take the earth. We don't want that to happen. So no, let's not do that.
I think there are not many question. Okay, so my point is that to audience or participants, when you just going to accredit through NAC, NAC prefers documentation. So you must have, what is the difference between regular regular person taking our waste TV or any other waste than Hulardek or any company is that the regular person taking the waste do not give any certificate or something. But we have to produce the certificates and other documents to NAC for the preparation of SSR. So that is the basic difference between a regular person to a company. So better you just associated with a particular company for your waste management. Now, I think there is no more question. Before we end, it is at the time of the end. So before we end, there is two announcements actually. We are going to organize several webinars in the banner of Gurudas College. And next webinar will be on 13th, this Monday at 3 p.m. The topic is coping with stress. And coping with stress, the speaker is Dr. Mrinal Mukherjee. And it is very much essential for our regular stress management for students, teachers, and support staff. So please join with us. And next, another next webinar will be on 18th July, next Saturday at 4 p.m. And it is in Bengali language. And the speaker will be the famous Professor Pobitro Sarkar. And the topic will be in Bengali, Mukto Chinta O Bohuttobad. So please join with us. I think there is another question. So please answer this and try to conclude the program with formal vote of thanks.
I'm sorry, I do not understand the question. When you say micro waste, what do you mean?
Waste from, I think, microbiological lab or any other things.
I'm sure there is, but overall, any waste affects animal and plant diversity if it is not disposed of properly. So I'm sure if there is microbiological waste as well, it does affect plant and animal diversity, because there is no waste that causes good to the environment. I think all human waste, rather man-made waste, is environmentally detrimental. So therefore, I'm sure that is also
right. So thank you, Mr. Nandan Mall, on behalf of Gurudas College. And another announcement is that our feedback form is available in our registration website. So please fill up the feedback form to get the participation certificate, number one. And now formal vote of thanks on behalf of Gurudas College. I thank Mr. Nandan Mall. He gave us his time to present this emerging issue on waste management. So thank you, sir, again and again from the college. And thank you all the participants from different colleges, different portion of the country, as well as from the abroad. So please be associated with us. We are organizing several webinars on several topics, maybe known, maybe unknown to you. So please be associated us. And we just want to conclude this program. Thank you to all and goodbye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.